These I cut out of felt. And then I used my white and I did the back. I poked it all in the back. Put a little bit of the vermilion in here. This is my reference. Okay. Gotta work on his legs. Gotta build up the back of him, because then he's gonna go on standing on the cow like that. Which I got all the white in here, and you can see the blue. He needs a little haircut. His mouth. I added some wool on here because I'll probably pin him through the back when he's in the frame. So let's work on the feet. Gotta make this real dense so he's not flimsy. Alright, so really condense the legs because that has to support the pig. Make him too long either, because it looks like he has short legs. But by the time I condense this down, it should get shorter. Plus I gotta add on to the back. I'm gonna mix this color and white and some pink to do his body. So those three colors, vermilion, pink, and white. And I can add more of the vermilion to make it darker underneath. Okay. You don't want to add your color until you get your animal. See, he's a little too spongy. He needs more poking. Add that in there. Gotta get this leg nice and firm. Mm-hmm. dog toe back here. Mix some brown to go in there, maybe with some of that for his hoof, like split foot. And so this comes up into here, and then look at how that belly comes down, so that belly comes down to, I guess, his knee. So I gotta add a lot more on there. Body slopes this way. Seems to be more bottom heavy than chest heavy. Let's get the front part of him on here. So you can just twist your wool up. Saves time in the poking if you bunch it up beforehand. And this top part I'm gonna leave for his shoulder. Make that thicker, so shape as you go. All the little parts you can add after you get your main shape done. Front legs are thicker than the back. It's got a big knee on there. So I'll think about shaping that now. Pick up and turn your wool so it's not all poked into your cushion. Plus you want to work all sides. Pull this part off. This part will act as a shoulder. About your position. That seems about right. So do the underside. Nice pork shoulder. Now this needs more beef on it. Because this goes over that part. Alright, so this needs a lot more poking. Thought maybe for his tail use a little bit of wire. And the trick I found for this that should be plenty is to condense your fiber first, then shove the wire up in there. That works better. Been trying to poke around the wire the whole time. As you can see, I'm twisting this up as I go. Got way more wool for a tail than I need, but I can always cut it off, so that's a good thing. So I want to be able to make it curly cue. Now I'm going to use my plastic guard. That way I can really poke the wool without poking my fingers. And this you have to keep turning or else you get a flat tail. So that's probably enough of it. Let's see. Let's get this wire through here. So now I can always add. So you can see some of the wool, you can see the wire through the wool. This way it is a little quicker than, you know, poking the wire around it from the beginning. At least this has something to grip onto in there. You don't want any of your wire showing. Pretty good. Let's try this side. The tail too fat either. I'm going to put this color around it too. Now I leave this part so that when I stick that into the pig, then I can knit this all into the back side. Right? So I'm going to put that in there and I'm going to bend it around and then poke the fur, the wool around it. and it'll be in there nice and sturdy. But I gotta get this tighter. That's a little lighter wool, which is fine. I don't want your color too uniform anyway. See, I think the whole tail is too fat. Just gotta get it more condensed. It takes a while. I want to get it in there and then be able to, there we go. That way, if I have this side, I can bend this over and then knit around that. See, that side came out. Damn. Bend this much. So I won't pull it out of the rest of this tail because I need to curly cue it. Is it in there? That's the question. See, it's right there. It up just like putting elastic in a pants band. I want to knit that wire into place so it stays there. This in here seems like it's in the right spot. I can leave this straight before I curly cue it, and I can condense it a little more. This guy needs a lot of work. All this is just a basic shape, but I've got to go in and condense this, shape the shoulder. Squeeze down this little piggy tail. Make sure it's all in there. Make sure my wire doesn't move. Now see, I've got to re-round the buttocks. This is coming up way too high, so I don't want that there. Just gonna take that down. Keep this nice and round. Now I don't want my pig to get too big for my cow. Now my wire is somewhere gone in there. Somewhere in there is my wire. So that didn't work very well. Maybe I rushed it, not condensed enough in there. So look, I have no, okay. Don't think of it as a failure, think of it as a challenge. So, what could I do? I could curl my tail, right? And then knit it. And then that would stay together. Right? Kind of like that. But I still think the tail's too thick. Dense it down. Okay, so I don't want to bore you. I mean, it takes a while, right? So now here's my wire that somehow fell out of my tail. Maybe I can get them out, but see, I knitted it on this side, didn't I? Yep. So we'll pull it out this way. Bloop. All right. So much for that. Maybe what I'll do is I'll get this on here better. And then jam the wire up in there. That's what I think I'll do. Straighten this. Oh, that wire poked me. So I want a nice little hook on here. I'm cutting this off like that. All right. This way. Stick it in this way. Down into the tail. This will hook into my fibers and then I'll condense that down. So anyway, there's much work to be done in this. I gotta make another leg. Oops, sorry about that. Curl this tail, color him in the pinkish color, and then he'll be standing on top of that. Okay. Little piggy. All right, well, I spent most of my time trying to make the color on this look even. And so there's the little pig. I got his tail curled. I ended up shoving the wire in from this direction. And then I wrapped it around the end of a paintbrush. And then I tacked it in, you know, like that. So this side I don't have to do. And it's hard when you're using a light color to get everything even. I mixed some pink, some this orange, and this vermilion color, along with some white, so that, you know, it has some modulation. And it's gonna go, I'm gonna knit his hooves onto the top of the cow. And now I've got to start the lamb. And then there'll be a little rooster. So that'll be my next video. But there's the little pig. And that's about it. So, quite a bit of poking, and I've added some meat on this hock so it'll support better when he stands on the cow. See his nose. I suppose I'll just get a haircut. And that's that.